to go foraging?
Foraging?
We're going to get some seaweed.
Let me get some there. It's just two
minutes. No, not that. I have some special stuff for you. Let's go. We got to suit you up.
The main coastline is stunning, but also too rocky to run our boat up to it, which means we'll be wading to shore, or at least that's what I was told.
We gotta jump in. You gotta jump in first, and then I'm gonna hand you these baskets.
You said we're going foraging up to waist deep. That is not waist deep in there.
You go first, and I'll hand you this, and then I'm gonna
push up. Seriously?
We dropped the anchor, and she said, in you go.
Are there any sharks in there?
Oh, yeah, we had great white last.
There's sharks in there? Oh, my God!
Ready?
You're mad!
Trust me, it's 10, 12 foot deep water, and it's bloody freezing.
Well, that was a first. What type of seaweed are you looking for?
So this is bladderwrack. We're going to get some of this.
That's called bladderwrack?
Yep.
Wow, it's amazing. I mean, this is in abundance, isn't it?
Yeah, and when you blanch it, it gets really bright and beautiful. Wow. Here, this one is the Irish moss. It's what we use to make like a blancmange.
So almost like a natural gelatine.
That's exactly what it is.
Wow.
This one, they call this the truffle of the sea.
Oh, really? That is crazy because it doesn't smell of salt. It smells of
earth.
Truffle. That is ridiculous.
I've never come across that. It was so fragrant.
It's like being back in Elba. It's an Italian truffle.
I know, it is.
That
is
incredible.
The truffle of the sea.
Wow. If that's just the tip of the iceberg, can you imagine what lays beneath those waters?
How many times a week would you come out here?
Oh, a couple times a week, you know, if I need to get some fresh seaweed.
Even in the fall?
Absolutely, year round. You know, Mainers are hardcore. You're salt of the earth right here.
Are you saying that I'm not a Mainer?
Well, I mean, Scotland, Maine, come on. We're going to see what you got this week, Gordon. There's 3,500 miles of coastline here. This week, I'm going to make this your job to figure out what we have on this beautiful coast and what we can do with it. Bring back some bounty of Maine goods and see what we can do. Cook together.
Excellent.
So, the challenge is set. Melissa tells me, if I want to be considered a true Mainer, I'll have to impress her friends at the Big Cook.
We're hardcore. We gotta see what you got.
But Melissa's dishes will be setting the standard. And if her food outshines mine, I'll never be accepted as a Mainer. So I'll have to bring my A game.
You're on, girl. You're on. Excellent.